goodness. We thank you for your love. We thank you for your faithfulness. There is none like you, Jesus. Blessed be thy holy name, O God. Be magnified, be lifted up on high. Lord, even as we start this service, we welcome you, Lord. We invite your presence in this place, that you just minister to us, Lord. That your glory be made manifest in our midst, O Lord. Father, we bless you, we worship you, we thank you. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You can shake someone's hand, just smile at them. Welcome them.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
We want to give God the highest praise in this place. Amen.
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 Lord good? Isn't the Lord good? Come on, just put your hands together. Just exalt Him, magnify Him. In the beauty of holiness, He's worthy. You're worthy, Lord. You're worthy, Lord. You're worthy. You're worthy, Lord. Hallelujah. Umejinulia malaika wakuba budu. Ndiyo maana mimi nasema. Oh,
none that is greater. To declare that you are supreme, to declare that there's no greater name in heaven, on earth, or below the earth that deserves to be worshipped. We thank you for gathering to us together this morning under the banner of that name, the name of Jesus Christ. Because at the name of Jesus Christ, every knee will bow, every tongue will confess that Jesus is Lord. So we come before you to declare that you are almighty. We come before you to declare that you are exalted. We come before you to declare that you are King of kings and that you are Lord of lords, because there is none that is greater than you. Father, thank you for gathering us together. Your word says where two or three are gathered in your name, that you are there in their midst. And we confess your presence in our midst this morning as we begin our service. We say thank you because you are in our midst. And we ask that you lead us, that you guide us, that you teach us, that you bless us, that you encourage us, that you mold us, and that you shape us to become like you. So we thank you for the joy of being in your presence and gathering in community to worship the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Amen. Amen. Can we just bow? Take our seats for a minute. We would like to share in communion as we begin our service. Please stand to someone next to you and tell them, welcome to our meal. I'd like you to invite them for the meal that we're just about to partake together. We're going to share the elements in a bit. Ushers, if you could just hold on. Just hold on a minute. We're going to be sharing in the elements in a bit. But I just want to say something about this meal, so that as we receive it with such greater significance. One of the greatest joys for any family or group of friends or any community is sharing in a meal together. It's one of the most special moments for any family. And for us as a family, as a spiritual family, this should be one of our most special moments. Sharing in this meal, because this is not just any meal. This is such an important, significant, and historic meal. In fact, the history of this meal is in the Old Testament. Many of us know the story of how the children of Israel were released from slavery by the hand of our Almighty God through Moses, the deliverer. But the night before they were released, God specifically asked the children of Israel to do something. He told them to slaughter a lamb, and the blood from the lamb should be placed on the doorposts of every one of the Israelite homes. Then after that, he told them to bake unleavened bread and to take this unleavened bread together. Immediately after, we see them experience the Passover of death, or the conquest of death, but also the release into freedom, into their place of inheritance that God had actually given them. As a reminder of the power of God, as a reminder of the freedom that was gained, as a reminder of the deliverance over death, later on, God asks the children of Israel to share this meal together regularly to be reminded. But in the New Testament, Jesus Christ gives this meal renewed significance, where he says, I, Jesus, are the Lamb of God that takes away the sins of the world. He was a lamb without blemish, without stain. And he, as that lamb, was now placed on the cross. His blood was shed, and we get the opportunity to celebrate the victory that Jesus Christ won over death once and for all, for all of us. But he also said his body was broken. He was battered and beaten, and his body was broken. As a symbol of that bread that they broke, he says his body was broken so that we could have healing and so that we can have salvation forever. So I'd like, as we share these elements, as our ushers graciously now distribute the elements, would you take those elements as something so special, as a great and significant reminder of what Christ did on the cross for our sins and what Christ gave as a sacrifice of his own body so that we all could be able to be free. Here at Nairobi Chapel Karen, we share an open communion. If you have given your life to Jesus Christ as your personal Savior, you may be visiting with us, or you may recently have joined us, you're welcome to this table, because this is the table of those that have accepted Jesus Christ as their personal Savior. They know what Jesus Christ has done on the cross for them, and today they are celebrating this in remembrance of the sacrifice that Jesus made. So as our ushers wait on us, I ask that as you receive the elements, please hold on to them. We're going to share these elements together, but I just want to ask that you bow your head in reflection after you have received the elements, and just take a moment this morning to rededicate yourself to God as our worship team continues to enable us to share this communion in reverence and in prayer and in supplication to God and in remembering what Christ did on the cross. When we're done, we're able to partake these elements together. Worship team, if you could just lead us in a moment of reflection.
Yes, mountain, and it flows to the lowest valley. Oh, the love gives me strength from day to day.
So, Father, as a community of faith, we are ultimately united by the work that Jesus Christ on the cross, he did for us. And this morning we come before you to say thank you in remembrance of what it took for us to be such a loving, caring, spiritual community, for what it took for us to be free, for what it took for us to have everlasting life. Father, we thank you for the opportunity to do this in remembrance of that great sacrifice that Jesus Christ did on the cross. And today we want to together come before you to say thank you. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. I'd like us to rise to our feet as we pass the cups to the aisles. Our worship team will lead us in one more song of worship as we continue to worship and celebrate the King of Kings.